Hi, in this video, I want to show you how to turn a mere user form textbox into a calendar drop-down or a date picker. It's easy. All I need to do is to write a single line of code on the mouse down event of a textbox. In this simple user form, there is a textbox for data capturing. For now, this is just a mere textbox. Therefore, I will double-click on this textbox and find its mouse down event. Within this event, I will write date picker and then press the period sign on my keyboard. If I do that, I get several methods to choose from. However, I'm only interested on these two methods. As you can see, I can apply a custom date time format or a specific VP date format. For now, I will select Apply Date Time Format and press the space button on my keyboard. Look at this. I have all the available VP date formats plus several optional parameters. If I choose General Date, this textbox will run a time picker because by default, the General Date format gives you a date and time as it appears on your PC right there. If I choose the Short Date format, and then click on the text box, I will get a date picker. And when the date is selected, the date picker will apply the required short date as it appears on your system settings right there. The same applies to the long date. You get the date picker, and the date is applied in a long date format specified in your original format settings. If I want a short time, I get a time picker. And the result when time is applied is an hour and a minute time. If I want the result to include seconds, I will have to choose a long time format instead. Sometimes these default date time formats are not enough depending on what we want to do. If you want to use custom formats, you can use the custom date time format method instead. Just watch and see how I do it. I want to get a short time format, but I want the time to be displayed in a 12-hour format showing the result as AM or PM. To do this, I will select custom date time format, press the space button on my keyboard and then specify my string format like so. Now if I run the user form and then apply the selected time, the result will be shown exactly as I specified. If I want a long date and time format, I will have to change my custom format like so. You can play around with the custom formats, bearing in mind that the date time format specified determines whether you get a time picker or a date picker. If you are not familiar with custom date formats, write the word format on your code editor and then press the F1 key on your keyboard. If you do that, you will be taken to a Microsoft page that explains everything you may need to know about date formats. The date textbox parameter is used only if you want to call the date picker from an icon and if you want to bind the date picker to a worksheet textbox. For example, if I put a date icon here like this, and I want the date picker to run on this textbox when a user clicks on this icon, I must write the code on the mouse down event of this icon the same way as I wrote it on the mouse down event of the textbox. However, this time, I must specify the target textbox by writing the object name right here. Now if I run the user form and then click on the icon, the date picker will run accordingly. These variance parameters are for adjusting the variance in positions, that is, in case there is a misalignment. As you can see, by just placing 3 here and 3 here, the date picker's top and left positions will shift accordingly. As for me, I don't need to adjust anything, so I will remove the adjusting figures. However, if you notice any misalignment, please use these parameters to realign the date picker.